So, Kyobok-soon is a South Korean action film, and the first time that I saw this trailer, I was thinking this is very similar to John Wick because if you have seen this trailer, you'll know that it's about a top assassin in an organization of assassins living in a world of assassins, and Bok-soon is at the top. She is known, respected, and feared, but she actually wants to get out of this world. She could spend more time with the person that she loves the most. And so, yeah, sounds a lot like John Wick, but is Kyobok-soon just another John Wick ripoff, or is it something else? So the general story here is that we have Bok-soon, more commonly known as Kyo Bok-soon, because she is the best at what she does, namely killing. But now, after all of these years, she actually wants to get out of this world and get out of this lifestyle because, well, she's actually a parent to a teenage daughter, and that's where she wants to spend her time, and that is who she loves the most. However, she has a lot of strong ties to this organization and to this criminal underworld because the person who heads this organization has very close ties to her. And there's also people in that organization that simply don't like Bok-soon. And then she also has this whole colleague teams, just people that she's worked with for a long time who are also assassins. And in a lot of ways, that's really her entire life. You know, she lives, breathes, and kills in this world. And it's not simply easy for her to finish her contracts and get out. And that's kind of like the overall general story, but there's actually more to it than that. So let's start off with, I would say, the best part of this movie. And it's not what you would think, because if you were thinking this is going to be all action and it's going to be very similar to John Wick, once you watch the movie, it's really not that. So in this case, the best part of the movie is actually its story, because here we're really spending most of our time with Bok-soon and her daughter. So it's more about this relationship of her with her daughter, but also her being a top assassin. So a lot of times when you see these types of movies like a Taken or something, you know, they are top assassins, but they also have a family. However, you don't spend a lot of time with that family and also seeing how this works. In this case, Bok-soon explores that. Like, how would you be an assassin parent, in this case, a single mother, dealing with a teenage daughter who's going through a lot of her own life pains and growing pains in school, you know, dealing with emotions, dealing with relationships, not really knowing her mother for obvious reasons, but at the same time, Bok-soon doesn't really know her daughter. And so it goes through all of that. And at the same time, Bok-soon also has deeper relationships with certain people in her organization and also people that she works and kills with. And so there is a lot there. And that's what makes this movie different from other types of movies like this, because I've not seen an assassin killer movie like this where it spends a lot of time dealing with this whole parenting aspect while being a top assassin. So in that case, it does a really good job. And of course, the next thing that I really enjoyed about this movie is the action. Even though there aren't a lot of action scenes, whenever there is action, this movie delivers. It's brutal, bloody, violent, and just highly entertaining, and it's very stylized throughout. And I especially enjoy the scenes where they're showing you why Bok-soon is called Kyo Bok-soon, because she is really, really good at what she does, and she doesn't hesitate to kill whoever gets in her way. And I really did enjoy that. And so if you're looking for the action parts of it, this movie does deliver whenever the action comes. And another thing that I really enjoyed about this movie is the acting. And so if you are a fan of Korean movies, shows, just entertainment in general, a lot of people in this movie you will recognize, and they all do a really good job in this movie, especially our main character Bok-soon, played by Jeon Do-yoon. She is a veteran actress, very talented, and she does a really great job in doing the action stuff, but also many of the dramatic scenes as well. That's really where her acting shines in this movie. And everybody else, they play their character really well, very believable. And so if you're looking for good acting in an action film, this does deliver. Protect your online privacy and keep data brokers from selling your personal information by using Delete Me, the number one privacy information remover service since 2010. Sign up today and get 20% off your first order. For more information, check out the affiliate link in the description area below. So, getting into the negatives of this film, well, to be honest, I just wanted to see more Kill Bok-soon killing people, because the action is something that I was hoping we'd get a lot of, especially from the trailer. But unfortunately, there's not very many action scenes in this movie, which leads me to the other negative. Even though I said the story is the best thing about this movie and it does make a difference, it could also be a hindrance as well, specifically if you're looking for a pure action movie, because I kind of see like this movie in a lot of ways, it's like two separate movies. The dramatic parts, I think, are done really well. It serves the story, it helps build the characters, and overall, I really don't have too many complaints on that. However, when you put that in with an action movie, and then most of your movie is not about action, then it could actually disappoint some people. I myself did enjoy it overall. However, I think for a lot of people that are watching this, they might be kind of bored in some of those scenes, or even like kind of confused as to what they're watching. And so if you go into this movie not having the expectations of a pure action movie and just enjoying it as a whole movie, it being its own thing, then I think you'll get a lot out of this. So if you actually have any thoughts on Kill Bok-soon or any other action films that you've enjoyed recently, be sure to leave it in the comments area below. And if you did want to see more of my Korean movie and show reviews, I do have an entire playlist. I'll leave it in the description area below or up here.